That was the scene early this afternoon, California time, as the body of former President Richard Nixon landed at El Toro Marine Air Corps Base in Orange County, California, accompanied by members of his family. The motorcade then left El Toro to travel to Yorba Linda, to the Nixon Presidential Library and Birthplace, which is the scene you are seeing right now on your television screen. That's a live picture, Mr. Nixon's, President Nixon's body, there in the library's lobby, where mourners can come throughout the night to pay their last respects to Richard Nixon. Watching this event take place with us right now, Congressman David Dreyer of California. Mr. Dreyer, what are your thoughts?
Well, you know, this is a very emotional time for all of us. I frankly, Susan, was more saddened and moved by President Nixon's passing than I thought I would be. The reason I say that is that he's an individual who has overcome adversity on so many occasions that I assumed that he would live to be 100. Frankly, when he had his stroke a week ago Monday, I assumed that he would come out of it. And then as the week progressed, it was obvious that he was not recovering. And it became very difficult for many of us to hear this. And I was actually in Mexico when he passed on, and I had thought on Thursday, I attended the 33rd meeting of the U.S.-Mexico Interparliamentary Conference, and I thought of not going to Mexico because he was so ill. And then I thought, well, President Nixon would have wanted me to be dealing with one of our most important allies and deal with a situation which, as we all know, is very tough down in Mexico. And I was moved that when we opened our meeting Saturday morning, and now this is a country that has just had a major presidential candidate assassinated not long ago, at the beginning of the meeting, the leader stood up and we had probably a minute and a half of silence in the memory of Richard Nixon. We were meeting members of their Congress and ours were meeting down there. And so it's been a very tough time for a lot of people. And tomorrow morning, our delegation will be going to California. And the last time I made the trip that we'll be making tomorrow morning was when Mrs. Nixon passed away last summer.
Well, let's show our audience the scene of the crowds outside of the Nixon Presidential Library. A couple of small facts, because we've been watching this today and without commentary as the last event unfolded. Tell me where Yorba Linda is.
Yorba Linda is in Orange County, California, and I've never actually represented Yorba Linda, but I represent the area, all of the area that I now represent was in Richard Nixon's original 12th congressional district that elected him in 1946.
How far is Yorba Linda from
about,
Los Angeles?
About 45 minutes. Oh, Yorba Linda is probably about 45 minutes from Los Angeles, and Yorba Linda is about 45 minutes from the El Toro Air Base.
Give me some geographics from Los Angeles.
From Los Angeles, Yorba Linda would be to the south and east of Los Angeles. It's in the northern part of Orange County. And El Toro is further to the south and west.
What is characteristic of that land that is important to know if you're trying to understand Richard Nixon?
Well, Richard Nixon was born in Yorba Linda, lived the early part of his life there, and then grew up in Whittier. And these are the suburbs of Los Angeles. They are, I think, one of the most beautiful.